Here is a list of DaVinci shortcuts that you should know if you want to play DaVinci like it's a piano. Just a quick note, the shortcuts mentioned are for Windows. If you are on a Mac, replace Ctrl with Command and Alt with Option. Now, let's get started. Let's start without moving the timeline. Use JKL to scroll through the timeline. L means play, K means pause, and J reverses play. If you press L or J multiple times, you'll speed up playback. If you press K plus L or K plus J, you'll slow down playback by half. Press Alt and move your mouse wheel to zoom in and out of the timeline. The focus of the zoom will be the timeline scroller. Press P if you want to see your edit full screen. Press P again and you'll return to normal. Now, basic editing shortcuts. Press I and O to place an in and out point in the clip or in the timeline. If you press X in the clip viewer, you'll select the entire length of the clip. If you press X on the timeline, you'll select the in and out points of the clip under the timeline scroller. Use Alt plus I and Alt plus O to remove the in and out points respectively. If you press Alt plus X, you'll remove both. To insert a clip into the timeline, press F9. To overwrite a clip in the timeline, press F10. To replace the clip you're over with the timeline scroller, press F11. However, try to avoid the replace function, as it causes more trouble than it solves. To learn more about basic editing, check out my other video on the three-point method. Now, some useful shortcuts for trimming. The default mode for the mouse cursor is selection mode, which you can toggle on by pressing A. To toggle trim mode, press T. While in trim mode, modifying the length of a clip will also affect the total length of your timeline. In selection mode, modifying a clip won't change the timeline duration. Keep this in mind when editing anything with synchronized sound. If you're not careful, you might lose sync between video and audio when working in trim mode. You can toggle dynamic trim mode by pressing W. This feature is similar to Avid Media Composer's original trim mode. It places a timeline scroller between two clips and lets you modify the end and start of the two clips with single frame precision. To use it, click on one side of the clip and use comma and dot to remove or add one frame. Press Shift plus comma or Shift plus dot to add or remove 10 frames. To preview the result, press space and DaVinci will show you 2 seconds before and after the cut. Press W again to return to normal mode. If you want to rearrange the clips in the timeline, move a clip while pressing Ctrl plus Shift, and the other clips will slide along. This can create ghost frames, so remember to keep Snap enabled. To enable Snap, press N. What I like to do, though, is toggle off Snap while I'm working. If I need Snap, I start moving a clip, then press N while my left mouse button is pressed. Snap will turn on, but only until you release the left mouse button. If you want to change a clip speed, you can enable retime controls by pressing Ctrl plus R. A useful tip, there's a quick way to find where a clip in the timeline is located in your project. If you press F, the clip you're selecting in the timeline will load in the clip viewer. This is very useful if you want to find another part of the same clip without disturbing your edit. If you press Alt plus F, DaVinci will highlight the clip in the project. This can be helpful if you have multiple takes of the same action and want to try a different one. To disable or enable a clip in the timeline, press D. The clip will be grayed out, meaning you cannot see it. To enable it again, press D. You can zoom in and out of the frame in the clip viewer and timeline viewer by using the mouse wheel. If you want the video to fit the viewer again, press Z. This works both in the edit and color tabs. Now, let's move to color grading. First, serial nodes. To create a serial node after the one you've selected, press Alt plus S. If you press Shift plus S, you will create a serial node before the one you selected. To create a parallel node, press Alt plus P. To create an outside node, press Alt plus O. This will create a new node that inverts the mask you made in the previous node. This can be useful for vignettes or to strip effects, for example. To disable or enable a node, press CTRL plus D. You can also enable or disable multiple nodes at once by left-clicking and dragging in the node graph. Be careful though, the node you're working on will be affected regardless of its selection. If you are making a HSL key, you can see the content of your key by pressing Shift plus H. To bypass the color grading completely, press Shift plus D. This shortcut works in the Edit tab as well. To maximize the color window, press Shift plus F. This view is useful to fine-tune the effects. To see your grade full screen, press Ctrl plus F. Lastly, if you want to apply a saved still to a clip, you can do so by pressing the middle mouse button. You can also copy the grade from one clip to another by clicking the middle mouse button over the one with the grain you want.